The last theory which we are going to discuss is modern theory or synthetic theory, or it is also called as Neo-Darwinism. This theory is formed by taking the conclusions, or it is concluded from the two theories, that is Darwin's theory and from the mutational theory. From the findings of both of these theories, we have, or the scientists have made the last theory, that is modern theory, and it is also called as the Neo-Darwinism. There are two postulates of this theory. First one, genetic variability, and the second one is natural selection. Genetic variability and natural selection. Genetic variability means the change in the genetic structure or some kind of variations, and natural selection means the one character or the one organism which is fit or best suited to the environment or best adapted to the environment, that will be selected by the nature. This is called as natural selection. So, first we will discuss about the genetic variability. There are the four causes for this genetic variability. Or what is genetic variability? We can say that in every population, or what is population? Population is the where the individuals of the same species living in a same place. Jahan par same species ke individuals ek jagah par rehte ho, that is called as population. And what are these genetic variability? According to Darwin, there are variations in each population, and that variations are because of some genetic changes that exist in that population. And what is the cause, or what is the work of one individual in the population to transmit or to inherit that particular trait or the particular character from one generation to another generation? This is genetic variability. Variations are present in environment, and that variations are because of the genetic, because of the some genetic changes that exist in that particular population. So, this is genetic variability. There are four causes of this. They are, first one, mutation; second, recombination; third, hybridization; and fourth, genetic drift. These are the four causes of the genetic variability in the modern theory or the synthetic theory. We will discuss all the three, all the four causes in detail. The first cause which we will discuss is mutation. We will discuss this mutation in brief. So, these mutation can be of two types. क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन एंड अनदर वन इज जीन म्यूटेशन. दिस क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन इज अगेन ऑफ टू टाइप्स, मॉर्फोलॉजिकल म्यूटेशन और मॉर्फोलॉजिकल मॉडिफिकेशंस एंड ड्यू टू चेंज इन नंबर और वी कैन से दैट न्यूमेरिक म्यूटेशन. नाउ दिस मॉर्फोलॉजिकल म्यूटेशन, दीज आर अगेन ऑफ टू टाइप्स, दीज आर इंटर क्रोमोसोमल एंड इंट्रा क्रोमोसोमल, इंटर क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन एंड इंट्रा क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन. सो वी विल डिस्कस फर्स्ट अबाउट द इंट्रा क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन. हियर आई एम राइटिंग द इंट्रा क्रोमोसोमल एंड हियर इंटर क्रोमोसोमल. नाउ इंट्रा क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन, हियर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एडिशन. एडिशन मीन्स वेन वन पार्ट ऑफ द क्रोमोसोम इज रिमूव्ड एंड दैट पार्ट इज सॉरी नॉट अबाउट एडिशन, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिलीशन. यस वी विल डिस्कस इन इंट्रा क्रोमोसोमल मॉडिफिकेशन और द इंट्रा क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन. द फर्स्ट कैटेगरी विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस is deletion. What is deletion? In this, when the one part of chromosome is being deleted from that chromosome, then it is called as deletion. Suppose this is one chromosome, here it is centromere. Here one combination is present, X, Y, Z, A, B, C. This is one combination. So, when this X, Y, Z combination is removed, this is called as deletion. And what was remaining? This. This type of deletion, that one segment of the chromosome is being deleted, and that is the rest of the chromosome is remaining as it is. So that type of mutation is called as deletion, in which one segment is permanently deleted from that chromosome. And this deletion can be of two types. These are of terminal deletion and intercalary deletion. Terminal deletion is of like this, that when the segment of the chromosome is deleted from the terminal part or from the last part, it is called as terminal deletion. And the second type, intercalary, when the segment of the chromosome is deleted from the middle part, jab wo beech mein se kisi bhi chromosome ka kuch segment beech mein se delete ho jaye, then that type of deletion is called as intercalary deletion. The next one is inversion. In the deletion we have discussed that one part of chromosome is deleted, and in the inversion one part or the one segment of the chromosome is inverted or it is flipped to the 180 degree angle. So that is called as inversion. See here, this is the normal one and when inversion takes place. Suppose inversion is taking place for this segment, so it will become Z, Y, X, A, B and C. It will take a flip of 180 degree, that is called as inversion. This inversion can also be of two types. One is paracentric and one is pericentric. It depends on the, or it involves the centromere. Paracentric is those which not involve the centromere, and pericentric is those that which do not involve the centromere, and paracentric is that which involves the centromere. This is pericentric, which is not involving the centromere. If the inversion is happening between the segment, this A, B and C, this is involving the centromere, A, B and C, this segment is involving the centromere. So, when this becomes like this, C, B and A, then it is involving the centromere in its inversion. It is taking a flip by involving the centromere of that chromosome. Therefore, it is called as paracentric type of mutation, and pericentric when it is not involving the centromere, that is pericentric. This was intrachromosomal mutation. The next one is interchromosomal mutation. In this, the first one is translocation. Translocation means when it happens in the homologous chromosomes. When the part of chromosome is, suppose there are two homologous chromosomes, or translocation happens in the homologous type of chromosomes. So, when the two sets of chromosome, that which are homologous chromosome, from that one part of chromosome is being removed, and the another part of chromosome is also removed, and they change the that part of the, them, it is called as translocation. Suppose this is one chromosome and this is another chromosome. They exchange their segment X, Y, Z, A, B, C, and here this is the combination of this homologous chromosome. So, this segment of the chromosome and this segment of the chromosome, when they are being deleted or when they are removed and further they attach to the chromosomes like this, here this was the segment of chromosome 2, the ABC was the segment of the chromosome 2 which is now added to the chromosome 1, and XYZ was the segment of the chromosome 1 which is now added to the chromosome 2. So, this type of crossing of these segment of the chromosome in the homologous type of chromosome, this is called as translocation. And due to this translocation of the chromosome in the 22nd pair of the chromosome, when the translocation happens in the 22nd pair of chromosome in human beings, then it leads to the severe disease called as chronic myeloid. This leads to the chronic myeloid. This was the intrachromosomal first category, translocation, and the second one is duplication. What happens in the duplication? When the one segment of chromosome repeats it in the same chromosome or duplicates itself, or the same type of two segments are present in the single chromosome, then it is called as duplication. Suppose that this is one chromosome, it is having the segment A, B, C, D and E after the centromere. So, after duplication, suppose this segment ABC is being duplicated. So, after duplication, two sets of ABCs will be present, ABC, ABC and D and E. Two sets of ABCs will be present in the, or the two sets of the same chromosome part will be present in the same chromosome. This is called as duplication in the chromosome. This was the first type of mutation, that is chromosomal mutation, in which we were discussing about the first category, morphological modifications. Now we will discuss about the another one, that is change in the number or the numeric modifications. The numeric modifications, these are also of two types. It is aneuploidy and polyploidy. Aneuploidy and polyploidy. So, the normal diploid condition is called as euploid. Normal condition is called as euploid, that is 2n condition. When there is a change in this condition, or when there is a change in the euploid, then there occurs the aneuploidy. This aneuploidy are further of three types: autoaneuploidy, this aneuploidy, these are of further three types. These are hyperploidy, hypoploidy and mixed aneuploidy. Aneuploidy are of three types: hyperploidy, hypoploidy and mixed aneuploidy. What happens in hyperploidy? Normal conditions in is 2n. So, when there is a increase in the condition, hyperploidy is addition of one chromosome, that is 2n plus 1. This is called as trisomy, or addition of the one chromosome is called as trisomy. It is, exists in the 2n plus 1 condition. Hyper means zyada. So, it is adding some chromosomes. It is when it is 2n plus 1, then it is called as trisomy, and trisomy of the chromosome leads to various kinds of disease, like Down syndrome. Trisomy of the 21st chromosome leads to Down syndrome, and trisomy of 18th chromosome leads to Patau syndrome, or there are very trisomy of many trisomies of this kind of chromosomes, which leads to the many diseases. And the hyperploidy is responsible for this trisomic condition. So, one is 2n plus 1 when only one chromosome is added, that is 2n plus 1. Another condition is 2n plus 2 when the whole set of chromosome is added to the another chromosome, then it is 2n plus 2. Hypoploidy, it exists in 2n minus condition. एक क्रोमोसोम में से एक क्रोमोसोम का घटना, दैट इज 2n माइनस 1, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज मोनोसोमी, एंड 2n माइनस 2, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज नलीसोमी. पूरा क्रोमोसोम ही कैंसल, in this one pair of chromosome or the one chromosome is removed, and in this the whole chromosome is removed. Therefore, it is monosomy and it is nullisomy. Mixed aneuploidy. Mixed aneuploidy mein kya hoga? It is the combination of the hyperploidy and hypoploidy. So, yahan par chromosome judte bhi hain aur kam bhi hote hain. That is called as mixed aneuploidy. And polyploidy. What is polyploidy? Addition of the chromosomes. Isme sirf chromosomes ka addition hi hota hai. This polyploidy are further of three types. Autopolyploidy, allo polyploidy and mixed polyploidy. Autopolyploidy means when the same set of chromosome is being added. Suppose the normal conditions is AA, then another AA or the same set of the chromosome is added, then it will lead to the autopolyploidy. Allopolyploidy, when the set of the chromosome is AA, and when the another type of set of chromosome like DB is added to the chromosome set, or when the two different type of chromosome sets are added, then it is called as allopolyploidy. And mixed polyploidy, combination of both this autopolyploidy and allopolyploidy, that is called as mixed polyploidy. This was all about the first category of the mutation, that is chromosomal mutation. Now we will discuss about the second category, gene mutation. When there is a change in particular point or particular place which leads to the change in the structure or the function of gene is called as gene mutation. Jab change koi particular point pe ho, then it is called as gene mutation. Particular gene ke point par ho, then it is called as gene mutation. And this leads to the change in the structure and the function of the gene. Uska structure change ho jayega aur the function will also be hampered by the gene mutation. In this, we will discuss about the point mutation. Suppose this is the nucleotide chain. This is the nucleotide chain, and one nucleotide is added at this place. We know that the nucleotide are in the combination of three. AUG is one, CAA is one, and CTT is one. So when any nucleotide or when any structure, when any nucleotide will be added in between this. Suppose cytosine is being added, so it will become ACU, GCA, ACT and T. So this will change the whole structure of the nucleotide chain. Yahan par एक न्यूक्लियोटाइड के ऐड होने से पूरा चेन ही चेंज हो गया. एंड दिस चेन सपोज इट इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म द प्रोटीन, और सपोज इट इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म द पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ प्रोटीन, देन इट विल नॉट फॉर्म दैट प्रोटीन बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एडिशन ऑफ द साइटोसिन. क्योंकि इसका तो पूरा स्ट्रक्चर ही चेंज हो गया, इसके पूरी कोडिंग्स ही चेंज हो गई है. तो कोडिंग्स के चेंज होने से हाउ इट विल गोइंग टू फॉर्म द पर्टिकुलर प्रोटीन for which it is being coded. Jis protein ke liye iska code kiya tha, these are called as codons. These codons were made for the coding of particular type of protein. To jab ye codons hi change ho gaye, to then how it will form that protein? This is called as point mutation. And Here we have talked about the insertion. When the particular nucleotide is being deleted, agar ye delete ho jaye, then what will be the combination? It will be like this, AGC, AAC and TT. This will also change the codon, this will also change this nucleotide chain or the nucleotide structure. This type of mutation is called as point mutation and also frame shift mutation. Point mutation or frame shift mutation. Now, one more type, that is transition. When we are talking about the in the same point mutation, transition, what happens in transition? Suppose there is one nucleotide chain and one pyrimidine or the one purine is replaced by another purine, then it will be transition. Or one pyrimidine is replaced by another pyrimidine, that is also called as transition. And transversion, when one purine is replaced by the pyrimidine or when one pyrimidine is replaced by purine, these are called as transition and transversion. Some more kind of mutations are also there, like nonsense mutation, missense mutation and same sense mutation. So what happens in the nonsense mutation? When one particular nucleotide chain is going to form a polypeptide or going to form a some amino acids, then the nonsense codon, amber, opal and ochre, that the three are the nonsense codons. When these nonsense codon come in the way of that nucleotide chain that is going to form in the way of that nucleotides that is going to form a particular polypeptide, then it is called as nonsense codon. And what happens in the missense codon? When the particular chain or the when the particular nucleotide is going rise to the variant type of the polypeptide or the some other type of the polypeptide or some other type of amino acids, then it is called as missense codon. This we can say the we can explain it with the example of the sickle cell anemia. What happens in sickle cell anemia? In the hemoglobins beta chain, at the sixth position, there is normally the presence of glutamic acid. When that glutamic acid is being replaced by the valine, then this is the case of missense mutation. Normally the glutamic acid have to be present at that position, at the sixth position of the hemoglobin, but due to some mutation, that glutamic acid is being replaced by the valine. Therefore, it is called as missense type of mutation. And what happens in the same sense? When the particular codon is being suppose the particular amino acid is being forming the same polypeptide chain or the different type of amino acid. One code or one amino acid is having different types of codon. For example, valine is having four types of codons. So, agar valine ke pas mein char type ke codons hai, to agar uska koi bhi combination kahin pe bhi present ho, then it will give rise to the valine only. This is called as same sense type of mutation. Even though the combinations of that codon are different, uske combinations different hai, then also it will give rise to the same kind of amino acid, that is called as same sense mutation. This was all about the mutation. There are two categories, chromosomal mutation and gene mutation. Chromosomal, morphological and numeric mutation. Two types, intrachromosomal and interchromosomal, deletion, inversion, translocation and duplication. And when we are talking about the numeric mutation, there are of again two types, aneuploidy and polyploidy. When we are talking about the aneuploidy, there are three types, hyperploidy, hypoploidy and mixed aneuploidy. And in the polyploidy, again there are of three types, autopolyploidy, allopolyploidy and mixed polyploidy. And when we are talking about the gene mutation, we have talked about the point mutation. In point mutation, there is the insertion of any nucleotide or the deletion of any nucleotide. That is also termed as frame shift mutation. And the transition and transversion, when the purine is replaced by the purine or the pyrimidine is replaced by the pyrimidine, then it is called as transition. And transversion, when the one purine is replaced by another pyrimidine or the one pyrimidine is replaced by another purine, then it is called as transversion. This was all about the mutation or the factor or the one factor which is responsible for the genetic variability. The next factor which is responsible for the genetic variability is recombination. Recombination happens when at the time of crossing over. When recombination happens at the time of crossing over, when the homologous chromosomes, they having a vertical split. Jab homologous chromosomes mein vertical split hoga, then they will form the sister chromatids. Wo sister chromatids banayenge. And when the two sister chromatids, suppose these are the two sister chromatids, and these two sister chromatids of the non-homologous chromosome, they recombine with each other or they cross over with each other, then they share the genetic properties or they exchange the genetic material of both these. So this leads to the recombination at the time of the gamete formation in second meiotic division. जब second meiotic division चल रहा होगा, जब gamete formation होगा, then when the two sister chromatids recombine or when they cross over, they exchange their genetic material, which leads to the recombination, and this is the second cause of the genetic variability. The third factor is hybridization. What is hybridization? When the animals of the two different species, suppose we are taking an example of the horse and a mule. Suppose one horse and one mule, they started mating each other. They are from different species, they mate with each other and they gives rise to an offspring, that is mule. So when the organisms from the two different species gives rise to the another organism which is bearing the characters of both of these two different species, then that offspring or that animal which is being resulted by the combination of these two species, that is called as hybrid, and this procedure is called as hybridization, or this act is called as hybridization. Two different species, when they combine with each other or when they mate with each other, the result which is going to happen is having the properties of both of these species. That result is called as, or that organism which is bearing the properties of both these species is called as hybrid, and the process is called as hybridization. The fourth factor which is responsible for the genetic variability is genetic drift. What is genetic drift? It is elimination of the genes or the alleles from the population. Elimination of the genes or allele from a population. Particular gene ya particular allele ka matlab, in this there is no particular type of gene or particular type of allele is eliminated. Koi bhi random type of gene or random type of allele is being eliminated from the population. So this elimination is called as genetic drift. and the reason of this elimination can be anything, like the disease or the death of all that species, death of the species which were having that gene or which were having the alleles. So because of the death of whole species, that whole gene is being eliminated from that population, or due to some disease or due to some endemic situations in that particular population, some gene or some allele is being eliminated randomly, then it results to the genetic drift. This genetic drift can happen in any type of population. Wo kisi bhi population mein ho sakta hai, chahe wo large population ho or it is the small population, but majorly it is observed in the small population, because if genetic drift is happening in the large population, so agar badi population mein ho rahi hai to usme se koi bhi gene ya koi bhi allele eliminate ho jaye, जब तक वो ज्यादा क्वांटिटी में नहीं होगा. सपोज इफ 100% इज द पॉपुलेशन, सो अगर वो 70% और 80% तक कोई भी जीन या एलील एलिमिनेट नहीं होगा, देन इट इज नॉट नोटिसेबल. नोटिसेबल नहीं होता है अप टू इट इज मैक्सिमम इन नंबर, बट इट इज रेडिली नोटिसेबल इन द स्मॉल पॉपुलेशन, क्योंकि स्मॉल पॉपुलेशन में अगर कोई भी जीन या एलील और एनीथिंग दैट विल बी एलिमिनेटेड फ्रॉम द स्मॉल पॉपुलेशन, दैट इज नोटिसेबल. सो दिस जेनेटिक ड्रिफ्ट इज हाईली नोटिसेबल इन द स्मॉल पॉपुलेशन. दिस वॉज अबाउट द जेनेटिक ड्रिफ्ट विच इज द लास्ट कॉज ऑफ द जेनेटिक वेरिएबिलिटी, which is the first postulate of modern synthetic or neo-Darwinism theory. Now we will discuss about the second postulate of this theory, that is natural selection. It was given by Darwin and it said that any variation which is best suited to the environment, that will be naturally selected by the nature and it will be inherited to the next generation. In this natural selection, we will discuss about some types of natural selection, so, and also some examples of natural selection.